The invasion had come at last. Houses Kassido and Sreethyn invaded the world of Resti Kell with the aid of the Empire. The rebellion came to House Kellerman's aid, landing troops to help fend off the invaders, and attacking their fleets in orbit with their fighter craft. Many of the enemy troops were landing at the same time, causing chaos. The battle would be played with two sections happening simultaneously. The game of X-Wing in orbit would involve ships coming in from all four corners. The Rebels are on the bottom right, and Imperials on the bottom left. House Kassido is in the top left, and House Kellerman is on the top right. The Kellerman large ships represent the light cruiser Dauben. The ship on the left represents the Imperial raider Guderian. Every other turn, if these ships are still operational and not firing at ships on their own board, they can fire barrages into the Legion game. The game of Legion has the disarray set up with rapid reinforcements to reflect the chaos of everyone coming into the battle from all locations as it happens. And the mission is sabotage. Houses Kassido and Sreethyn and the Empire are trying to destroy the signal towers placed across the buildings. House Kellerman and the Rebellion are trying to keep these intact since they keep coordination between various parts of the planet. Without it, the planet will fall. As always, this battle is much bigger, but this game represents an important part of that battle with key players. If the Rebels are able to win this battle, they get access to extra Kellerman troopers, AT-STs, and landspeeders. The Rebels had Lady Revis and Bron Kofa as commanders, with Rawara and Pejix Rabel as operatives. They had Wookiees, the AT-ST killing Zalarians, two units of troopers, three units of Kellerman troopers, a unit of Pathfinders, a sniper, two AT-STs, and a fully armed landspeeder. The invading armies were commanded by General Kalthor of the Empire, General Barazan of House Kassido, and General Tarek of House Sreethyn. They had an AT-ST, a pair of speeder bikes, two units of stormtroopers, a unit of death troopers, a tank, a unit of Kassido guards, two units of Kassido troopers, and two units of Sreethyn troopers. And of course, Kalthor was escorted by KXOO. The deciding battle took place in a town square with troops on all corners. There was a comm tower in each corner as well. Next to one tower were the House Sreethyn troops and the tank. Next to another tower was a sniper and House Kellerman troops with an ATRT on the ground. Near the tower across from them were the House Kassido troops and General Barazan with his guards escorting him. And by the final tower were Lady Revis, her troopers, an ATRT, and the landspeeder. She began by ordering her troops to press the attack, while her rival sent out suppressive fire. In orbit, Jake Fabree sent out quick orders to all the Rebels. The plan was to intercept the Imperials in the middle, disrupt their attack run, then make their own. Jethro, cover our flanks.
You don't need to tell me twice. Come on, Alex, let's shoot some bad guys,
Jethro shouted, and the A-Wing shot off to the left where they would duel the interceptors. The Kellerman ships turned toward the Rebel ships, and the Kassido ships headed toward the Kellerman light cruiser. The ships continued on their trajectory, with the Rebels and Kellermans turning toward the Imperials while Kassido and the Imperials continued beelining for the light cruiser. Off to the side, the interceptors and the A-Wings all fired at each other, but they were all too maneuverable to do any damage. The capital ships fired a bombardment onto the ground, and the raider hit the Rebel snipers while the light cruiser took out one of Barazan's guards. Bron was rallying his troops with propaganda, while General Tarek reminded her troops they were reinforced with body armor. The troopers exchanged fire. Kellerman couldn't get a single hit, but the Pathfinder sneaked up on the tank and got a hit on it. The landspeeder drove by and tried to put some more hits on it, but failed. The AT-ST with General Kalthor on board marched in and turned toward the fighting. Though flanking, it couldn't get a good angle on Lady Revis. But Kalthor called down to her droid, KXOO, who rounded the corner, focused in on her head, and fired, killing her instantly. In space, the Imperials reached the center, dodging the debris from earlier battles as they continued their beeline for the light cruiser. The A-Wings on the flank flipped around, ready to go at the interceptors, but they both spotted a strange wavering of the sky ahead of them. "Is that what I think it?" Alex Wrynn and Dagger 1, the secondary A-Wing pilot, started to say. But then Jethro, Dagger leader, shouted, "Phantom, shoot it!" They both launched their cluster missiles, and incredibly, both hit. The empty sky exploded before them. They both cheered, and Jethro said, "One less of those things!" The interceptors turned on the B-Wings. One of them was the Interceptor Ace. But Tessa Wayfella, Trident leader, was not intimidated. She had learned the power of the B-Wing and now used it to intimidate her opponents. "Hard right," she said, and Fern Tanoa, her wingwoman, turned with her. Fern had become a crack shot, and as soon as she was pointed at the interceptor, she fired and took it down. The ace was harder, and Tessa took more damage than she dealt, but she would get another chance.
Kellerman ships tried to swing around behind the Kassido fighters, but the Kassido ones got on their flanks, fired, and took out one of the lead ships. In the middle, the larger ships came head-to-head and pounded away at one another. The Imperial swarm kept going forward, and the Kellerman ships broke formation to get on two sides of the fighters, destroying one in the rear. X-Wings came around the other side, firing at the bombers, taking one of them out. The Kassido fighters came up right behind the Kellerman ones, firing with multiple hits, but the Kellerman fighters nimbly dodged all of them. The capital ships fired into the battle, and the raider hit some of the rebel reinforcements. The AT-ST and tank ganged up on the AT-RT and took it down. Imperial death troopers and speeder bikes came in as reinforcements on the side of the Empire. Kellerman troops came in on the opposite side, and they made their way toward the battlefield. They came face to face with KXOO, who stabbed through their armor with his arms, shot them with his pistol, and crushed their heads through their helmets. They tried to shoot back, and most of their hits bounced off his armor. On the opposite side, the Wookiees came in on the side of the Rebellion, climbing the side of the building to guard one of the comm towers. The Kassido guards charged them, impaling two of the Wookiees. The Wookiees lashed back along with other Kellerman troops who entered the fray, but they could hardly get a hit on them. On the ground, one Kellerman trooper stubbornly held on, and General Tarek charged him. Just behind her, the landspeeder zipped by and fired at the AT-ST, doing a little bit of damage to it. The AT-ST looked down, but couldn't manage a hit. The rebel troopers made their way to the back of the tank, trying to be sneaky about it, but half of them were gunned down by the death troopers. The Pathfinders charged to the other side of the tank, trying to get a solid hit on it. In orbit, the rebel ships were trying to swing around behind the TIE fighters and bomber, but the Kassido ships were getting in their way. The larger ships continued to trade shots. The Red Ace Interceptor flew after a target, but got in front of Tessa Wefella in the B-Wing, and she did not intend to let it get away this time. She fired and shot the Ace to pieces. The Kellerman fighters sandwiched the Kassido lead vessel and took it out, but then one of them was taken out by the other Kassido fighters still in formation. Jake Fabry and his wingwoman Zoe Zebweth flew through the thick of it, firing their ion turrets at enemy bombers. Jake had a tactical map of the whole battle and was calling orders to everyone. In doing so, he didn't notice a swarm of TIEs show up on his flank. Their shots tore through his shields, and he tried to pull away. But before he was able to, the second wave ripped through his hull, and suddenly his ship exploded. And the TIEs simply flew by without regard to the fact that they had just killed the Rebel Wing Commander. Most of the Rebel ships let them go. Zoe and the A-Wings followed them, but the rest of the ships went at the Raider. The Kassido fighters drove in at the Aurora. Like before, they got plenty of hits, but somehow the Aurora dodged all of them. All except one. It was a serious hit through the shields, though, and it caused a hull breach. Inrot's plane was in trouble. The A-Wings shot at a TIE fighter from a distance, and they got lucky hits. "For Jake," Jethro said. The other TIEs closed in on the light cruiser, and they exchanged fire with it. The bomber let loose its missiles. Together with the TIE fighters, they destroyed their shields, and the missiles disrupted their controls. On the ground, the Kassido soldiers were now rushing across the bridge to help fight the Wookiees, who had whittled the guards down to one. And then the troopers with them finished that last one off. The Pathfinders on top of the tank were all gunned down, but they had distracted the tank for just long enough. The troopers around the corner had managed to get to the back of the tank and fired into its vulnerable rear, blowing it up. Angry at what they had done, the Sreethyn soldiers rushed over the wreckage of the tank and shot down the rebels who had destroyed it. With the Kassido troopers now gone, Rawara and Pejix climbed up the comm tower they had abandoned. Ron Kaffa was heading to the one near the Wookiees to fix it. General Tarek used her rifle as a bat and smacked the one remaining trooper back several yards. The landspeeder continued on, shooting at the troopers on the bridge, but missing. The speeder bike slew up behind them, closing in. The Wookiees got to the comm tower and began repairing it, but Barazan shot them down, then took their place at the tower as the Kellerman troopers fired at him. In space, the Y and A-Wings continued to fire at the TIEs going at the light cruiser, taking both of the TIE fighters out. All that was left was the bomber and the decimator, which might be enough, but the light cruiser hit the bomber, blowing it to shreds. The decimator still fired, doing more points of damage. The light cruiser was halfway to destruction. The rebels were making their own attack run against the raider. It fired at them, but they dodged its shots. They fired all of their missiles, which they had a lot of thanks to the successful supply missions they had just run. And they tore through the shields and did hordes of damage to the ship, including disabling a turret and damaging its drive. The Kassido fighters split up, one going to defend the raider, the other going to finish off the light cruiser. The ships near the cruiser were now following the decimator, firing everything they had into it. They panicked the pilot, causing him to fly out of the battlefield. The others continued to close in on the Guderian. One more attack run should do it. The Raiders' guns desperately tried to shoot them down. They came one damage point away from taking out Captain Swiftlight, but he held on. They unloaded on the capital ship, and it exploded spectacularly. On the ground, Pejix was working away at the comm tower, trying to repair it. The Kassido troopers turned to fire on him, so Aurora charged them, lifting up soldiers and throwing them about. From across the town square, a sniper found Pejix and fired, wounding him, but not taking him out. He didn't let it deter him, but rather he kept working on the tower. At the foot of the building, KXOO was doing the same thing to the Kellerman troopers, tossing them about and wading through the unit until it was all dead. General Tarek got to the comm tower near here and destroyed it. Nearby, Sreethyn and Death Troopers searched for the rebel troopers that had gone hiding. They found them, but fired like stormtroopers and no one hit. The rebel troopers, unable to accomplish anything anymore, went running. Up on the roof, General Barazan continued to destroy the tower he had taken from the Wookiees, trying to dodge the Kellerman troopers near him. On the other side, Gronkoffa ran up to the comm tower and repaired everything Barazan was breaking. He didn't fight him, he just repaired right behind him. A strange sight in the middle of a battle, and Barazan didn't know how to handle it. He seemed to be destroying at the same pace Bronn was repairing. Then there were the Kellerman troops who fired at him, and he had to avoid. Soon Bronn had the comm tower fully repaired, and Barazan was having to retreat. The Landspeeder raced under the arch and turned a hard right. The speeder bikes rounded the corner behind them and were met with the AT-ST killing Zellurians. They blasted one of the speeder bikes and caused the other to fly off in another direction. Pejix was taking a lot of suppressive fire from the AT-ST, which caused him to duck for cover. There he wanted to stay, away from the rapid fire of the large metal beast and the shots of the sniper rifle. But he could hear the crackling of sound coming from the comm tower and the panicked voices from elsewhere on the battlefield. He knew that the Rebellion needed this. General Cloudman needed this. Pejix got up and continued his work on the comm tower. The AT-ST continued to pour fire on him. He felt explosions all around him. The building rocked. Laser blasts singed his body. But he had everything hooked up. All he needed to do was pull the power. The sniper fired and hit Pejix square in the back. Rawara looked at him horrified. The life was fading from his face.
Now, Cloudman, I would have followed him to the ends of the galaxy.
And as his body dropped, his hand remained clenched to the power switch, and he turned it back on. The comm tower was operational again. Rawara screamed in anger. He grabbed men in full body armor and ripped them in two. They shot him and he grabbed their guns, breaking them like toys. He threw them from the balcony into the walls of other buildings, always screaming in agonized anger. The AT-ST was moving toward him now, preparing to fire. Gronkoffa and the Kellerman troopers shouted for him that it was time to go. Rawara nearly did not leave. But he looked around and there was nothing left to kill, only body parts and blood. That pulled him together just enough to jump off the side just as the AT-ST blasted a hole in the bridge. Bronn and the others escaped down the wall as well, and they all hurried to the transport. There they took off and flew into the sky. In orbit, they joined the others. Though they had won the space battle, they had lost the ground. According to the scenario, they had kept two of the comm towers running while two were destroyed. That created a tie, so the deciding factor was the loss of points. In that case, the rebels and Kellerman most definitely lost. However, tying has to mean something for the campaign, so it meant that they still got one unit of every type from Kellerman, and two AT-RTs to use in a future battle. But in this case, the Empire and their allies have taken Resti Cal. The question now remains, who gets to claim it? While this was happening, other battles are taking place. Click on the battle you'd like to watch, or click the last link to continue to the next webisode. May the Force be with you, and happy gaming, everybody.